Guys, welcome to Excel tutorial channel again, and in this video of logical functions in Excel, we will cover the comparison operators in Excel. So what are those comparison operators in Excel? These are like equal to, greater than, less than, greater than or equal to, less than or equal to, and not equal to. So I know it's very confusing while I'm saying this, but we have covered like not equal to in our previous videos. If you haven't watched that, please do that, because you will catch up very easily in this video if you have learned basic logical functions like if, or, and, etc. Or if you haven't watched the if function video, which we have covered in detail, you can also do that. So if you haven't subscribed to the channel, do subscribe it, because in upcoming days we will be researching more and more about the Excel, and we will be giving you tips weekly, and we will also cover each and every functionality of Excel which will help you in your work life. So let's get started. So this is very basic example here for you, which is the product, old price and new price. So in this video we will just explore all the comparison operators and how you can use in your daily work life, or you can say Excel life. So what are those comparison operators? First we will discuss equal to operator in Excel. So how you can do that? If you want to find if old price is equal to new price, right? If you want to find that, you can easily do that with this. You must have figured it by now. So if I do this, it give me the boolean value here. Boolean values are either true or false. I don't know how you pronounce it, the boolean, or I don't know, because I'm not that fluent in English. If I apply to this all cells, then it will give me the false, or either false or true value. So if you want to cover it up with the other values, like yes, if it returns true value, you can name it like yes, and if it is false, you don't want to include anything, just leave it blank. So you can achieve that by if function, right? You have learned it. If you haven't, then do watch that video, it will be very helpful. So in this way, here I include the if function. So here the logical test, which is if new price is equal to old price, or old price is equal to new price. So if value is true, then it's a yes, right? If value is false, I just want to leave it blank here, and you can click here, so it just vanish it off because of the second logical. So here we got the yes, and those value which are false, it just leave it plain blank. So how you, this is how you can use logical operator like is equal to with the logical functions like if function. You can also apply your all other like some ifs etc. into this particular example. So this is a very basic example to tell you how you can deal with such operators and such scenarios. This was the first comparison operator, which is very straightforward, equal to. So next will be the greater than operator. So the greater than operator returns true if the value is greater than the second value, which is very straightforward, as you can say. So if I want to find if new price is greater than old price or not, you can easily do that with the help of this, right? And here you go, and you can do that. So this is very straightforward, as you can see. If I apply if function like here, like we have applied in the previous video, and I just want to find if my budget is like 100 rupees, and if I want to find if either those values comply to my budget or lies within my budget, so I will use the if function. So obviously I will use only the new pricing here. I just say new pricing is greater than 50 or not. So if value is 100, because my budget is 100, so value if true, then I will say just not in my budget, or you can just leave it blank here. And if value is false, you can also say yes, it's in my budget. Then here we will enter and click, double click on this, and we will apply to all. So Jack Daniels is not in my budget, so my budget is only 100 rupees. And here we have apples, which is also not in my budget sadly, so I can buy Limca, notebook, Mirinda, Coke, Pepsi, so all the junk stuff I can buy. So you can also use the different functions here, like if you want to find like if either of the prices lies in my budget or not. What does it mean if either new price lies in my budget or old price, just for your own curiosity. So what we're gonna do here is which formula we will apply if we just want one condition to fulfill. That function is OR function. So here the logical test, what will be the first logical test is old price is 100. What will be the second logical test? C2 is greater than 100. And if I close it down the parenthesis here and it says yes, false, and we apply it to all, it say either true or false or true. And if you want to, you know, just do that again, which we have covered, you know, I don't want to include all the, you know, true values here because my budget is 100 only. So if we will apply the if function here, so this all or function between the if function is our logical test. So if it you know revert true value, we just leave it blank. So if says the value if false, we will say yes, right? And we will close it down. So yes, we got here yes, and two values. Obviously we just can't afford Jack Daniels and apples, so let's just delete this and move on to the next part, which is the less than. So less than is also very straightforward, like we have used this. Okay, just to be, you know, clarify those stuff, I don't think you are that much idiot to, you know, to not get it till now. So if I want to know if new price is less than the previous price, so you can also do that simply with this, like this, right? It's very basic. And you can also apply to all. So it say no, false, all new prices are up from the old prices, either is equal to, as you can say, 2020 50 15, or it's higher than. Obviously inflation with the time, you know, things got expensive. So if you want to quote that these things up with the if or or function, you can also do that easily, as you know by now. Or let's just say examples. If we want to say, I want to know, you know, our budget was like 100 rupees. So I just want to know if both the prices, you know, just for the sake of curiosity, I just want to know if both the prices lies in my budget or not, you know. So which function we will use if we want to, you know, satisfy both conditions? So we use the AND function. So let's say less than 100, less than 100. So this here, so it say true, yes, it's less than 100 and it falls in your budget. And if I just, you know, format those true and false values with your custom criteria, you can also do that, because AND function will be our logical test, and value if true, then yes. Value false, I don't want to include anything, so yes, it falls in my budget. And here we go, you can do that also in the same way. So let's get on to the next part, which is the greater than or equal to. So greater than equal to, what does it mean? If it's greater than some value, like say 50 or equal to 50. So it's very basic. If you know the basic mathematics, then this will be very easy to resolve. So this will be very, you know, I just want to find if new value is greater than equal to the old price. It says yeah, true, these are all true, you know, it's they are either equal to or greater than the old prices. So you can also do that. Suppose you want to find how many new prices are greater than equal to 50. Okay, so how you gonna do that? You can use simple function, which is the count if function. If you haven't watched the count and sum function playlist, please do that, because we have covered each and every function in detail. So how we gonna do that? We just type count if here and select the range here. What will be the criteria? Our criteria will be greater than equal to 50. Why? Because we wanna find how many values are there which are greater than equal to 50. So this is a 4, first, second, third, fourth. Obviously it's equal to or greater than equal to 50. So these are the four values. So next will be the less than or equal to, which is also very straightforward. If you see, if you want to find if new price is less than equal to this, it says false. But if we apply to all, some says true. Why? Because it's also equal to the old price here, right? And in the same way we have covered in the previous, like COUNTIF function. If we want to count if new price is less than in our budget, we can also do that with the same formula. So if we want to find if how many products are there in the new price section are less than my budget limit, which was 100 rupees. So you can easily do that with the same method here. And we got the 6 number of products out of 8, I think, yes, which falls within our budget. Obviously, except Jack Daniels and apples, which are way, way expensive. So this is the another way. And we can also use the sum if function. We will use another function here, which is the sum if function. So we're going to find how many products are there in our sheet, which are less than equal to my budget. And we will sum it up. Okay, so we will sum it up all the values which are less than equal to 100, which is our budget limit. So we will use which function? Sum if function. Here we got the range here. What will be the criteria? Okay, and we click here. We got the 155. If we calculate all these values, it amounts to the same number. Hope you get to know, you know, how you can collaborate these comparison operators in your logical functions. So next and the last is not equal to, which is very, very basic, and we have covered this particular comparison operator in our previous videos. So this is very basic. If new price is not equal to old price, let's find out if it's true or false. It says true. The new price is not equal to the old price. If I apply to all, so these are the false values because these are the same. Coke, Pepsi and Mirinda, and this is all the same. Limca and notebook. So Jack Daniels and apples got expensive, so it's understandable. And if we want to wrap these up, we can use if function here. This will be the logical test. If you want to know new prices is not equal to old prices, then value if is true, you can simply include yes. And value false, you can simply say it's not equal to here. And we apply to this and it say no, these are equal to, which is the correct opposite to not equal to. So hope you understand how you can use these comparison operators in your daily work or Excel life, which is for the beginners. If you know about these stuff, then you can skip this video. Hope you like this video. If you learned something new in this video, please click the like button. If you have still questions, then you can use the comment section. If you haven't subscribed to the channel, please do that, because in the upcoming videos we're gonna cover each and every function in details. And we have also covered the count and sum functions, and we have also covered the if function. You should check it out in the description box. So see you in the next video. Until then, bye bye.